He made it possible.
Yes, yes.
That we all could come back to the place. Like where Adam gave up. Jesus came and bring us back. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In the book of Samuel, look what God said to Samuel. The book of Samuel, after Saul messed up.
Yes.
Amen? Amen? God tells Saul, go and kill everybody. Man, woman, children, and animals, everything. Don't leave nobody.
Yes.
And the Bible says Saul came back. Amen?
Amen.
And came back with a king called Haggai.
Yes.
And animals to make sacrifice.
Uh-huh.
Amen? But look what God tell in Samuel chapter 16. He's speaking to Samuel.
Yes.
Talking about the heart. Wow. And the Lord said unto Samuel, how long will you mourn for Saul? See that I do what? I have rejected him. Let me say this in the spirit of God. Partial obedience is disobedience.
That's right. That's right.
Come on.
Right.
Come on.
Can I say that again?
Come on.
Partial obedience is disobedience. Saul went to do what God said, but he didn't do everything what God said. He did partially. And God says what? It's disobedience. Amen.
Amen.
So yes, well, I'm just doing this and how they go do nothing half-hearted.
Yes.
I don't want to go ahead of myself. Amen. But God's saying here that he rejected Saul.
Amen.
Because Saul was doing, he was doing what he think he wanted to do. And God tells us to do something, do it.
Amen.
Whatever he said, do it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Remember when he was in the wedding? And they needed wine.
Yes.
And they came to Jesus about the wine.
Yes.
And the mother said to them, whatever he said,
yes,
do it.
Do it.
Do it. Do it. Sometimes things, it doesn't always look like it makes sense to God. Nothing makes sense to God.
Yes.
But you do it.
Yes.
Tell the Jericho and the amen, Joshua, to march on a wall.
Right.
And shout and it will come down. That didn't make sense. That sound like some people like nuts.
Yeah.
The march over the wall for 7 days in the hot sun.
Yeah.
Nothing happening the first day. Nothing happening the second day. But you know the story. Nothing God said. It makes sense. But if you tell it to do it, do it. Hallelujah. Amen. And God said to Samuel, I reject him for reigning over Israel. Fill thy horn with oil and go, and I will send you to Jesse the Bethlehemites. For I have provided me a what? A king among his sons. I provide me a king. The call of God on your life, you don't have to worry about nobody.
Uh-huh.
If God called you.
Come on.
You don't want to compare yourself with nobody.
Right.
Hallelujah. I provide. Love's going to put his hands on your life. You don't have to compete with nobody.
Right.
Preachers, compare yourself with preachers.
Yeah.
Amen. If God wants to give you a mega church, he give you a mega church.
Right.
Maybe you're ready for a mega church.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
While you can preach, do what he said. Just obey him and see how he bless you. It's in your obedience. What is your obedience God looking for?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Let me prepare you for that.
Amen.
Well, don't look at somebody and envy and
amen.
Amen. Because God has a plan.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
He have a plan.
He has a plan.
So what? Look at verse 7. What verse 7 says? But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not at what? The countenance of men. Don't look at men. Countenance. The height. The looks. Hallelujah. God said, don't look at that. And that's what men do. We look at the looks and the heights and everything and the color of the skin. God said, I don't look at that. Amen.
Amen.
I love that.
Amen.
And if you know the story, the Bible said that God, there were seven, how many brothers, five brothers? And none of them was God chose. But guess what? Some of us, they don't have nobody else. Oh my God, we have a young man. He minding look. What are you doing? He minding sheep. Maybe smelling like a sheep. But he wasn't invited. And God says, Simon said, bring him.
Right.
I knew that was the man.
Uh-huh.
David wasn't tall as his brothers.
Uh-huh.
But God said, this is the man.
Yeah.
I'm looking at his heart, and this is not the David that God said is a man after my
right.
own heart, a man that had problems.
Right.
He had woman problems.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. You know the story.
Yeah.
But God said, this is a man after my heart. That's amazing. They call it the sovereignty of God.
Yes.
So when God calls you, don't call and look at your shortcomings.
Okay.
You don't look at your hallelujah bad habits.
Yes.
Amen. You don't look at that no more. You look at what? The heart.
Because
yes. He knows what he can do with you.
Yes.
I ain't seen nobody praise God like David. Ain't nobody can praise God and worship God like David. Amen.
Amen.
This is the man who said, I will bless the Lord at what?
All
time, Lord.
Yeah.
And this is the man who said, I don't care what's going on in my life, I will give him the glory.
Yeah.
And I don't care what the position I'm in, I will give him the praise.
Hallelujah.
Isn't that powerful?
Yeah.
I'm telling you something. You look at their heart. So we got to stop looking at others and watch and judge at others. Out from y'all.
Oh God.
What God's seen in you.
That's
more imperative than anything else in your life.
You.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't look at somebody struggling. Don't put them down.
That's right.
Help them.
Yeah.
You know what God has in store for
us.
Hallelujah. Amen. And this is what God did. The Bible says, take the foolish things of the world to do what? Confirm the wise.
Nice.
The base things.
Nice.
Things that look like they don't make and have no significance.
Amen.
When God put his hands on you.
Amen.
When God put his call on you.
Amen.
Hallelujah to God.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for that. Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible says God anointed David and become the great king. So we see that God look at the heart. And God said to David here, to Simon here, for I look
at what? At the heart, and you look at the outward appearance.
Right.
Amen?
Amen?
In the kingdom, in our heart, we should not do nothing in the kingdom if our heart is not in it.
That's right.
You know something about the heart, again, in the spirit? It's when you get out of that, motive.
Yeah.
Why you want to sing?
Right.
Why you want to teach Sunday school?
Right.
Why you want to preach?
Right.
Why you want to lead the praise and worship?
Right.
Motive.
Right.
Lord have mercy.
Yeah.
Motive.
Right.
His motive is something else.
Yeah.
Do I want to show that I have a voice?
Right.
What we do for God, we must do from what? The heart.
Right.
Not a show business. This is not Hollywood. When we come in the house of God, this is kingdom business. Kingdom business. How can I promote the kingdom in my song? How can I promote the kingdom when I preach? How can I promote the kingdom? It's kingdom business.
Amen.
You come here to look at who wears shoes and what suit this one has or what clothes. I am about that. Kingdom business!
Yeah.
Blessing of the Lord.
Yeah.
must do for the heart. God, the first thing that we must do with our heart. The Bible says we should love the Lord thy God. With all of what? All of our heart. But God is saying, I don't want to be second place. I don't want to be, I don't want to be tied with nobody. I want you to love me with all of your heart. Somebody say all. There's no substitute for all. I want you to love me with all your heart. Isn't that something? I don't see this God, but you want me to love him with all in my heart. No, I don't see him. It don't make sense. What God said, I want you to love me. God! Isn't that something he said? Call it what? A great commandment.
Yes. Great commandment.
Great commandment.
Yes.
To love him. Amen. With all your heart. Amen. And we got to pursue this in our life. God comes first.
Yes.
Thank God for husband and wife. And I believe my wife don't love me more than God. The wife I have, she don't love me more than God. I know that. Hallelujah. If you think, when I'm hard, but God is all right if I love God and love my husband at the same. No, you don't. God don't want that.
Right.
You want to be only, not number one, because if you have number one, you might be a number two. You want the only lover. Amen. You got to learn to love the Lord with all of our heart. Oh, I love him with all my heart. He said, if you love me, you keep my commandments. Isn't that something? Not, this, hallelujah. This is how you love God. You don't love God by just saying it out. You love him by acting it out. Lord, my heart. Lord, I'm here to obey.
Amen.
I was like, in the army, to say, I'm at your command.
Yes.
Isn't that powerful?
Amen.
I'm at your command, Lord.
Whatever.
I'm here. I'm at your command, Jesus.
Amen.
He said, love him. We must love him all over heart tonight. Somebody said, love him.
Love him.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You don't love him enough. God, just continue to spend time with him. And see how much you're able to love him more.
Yes.
The more you spend time with God. Amen.
Amen.
More you spend time with God.
Yes.
You will get to love him more and more.
Yes.
Because
yes.
He can begin to reveal.
Yes.
He will begin to reveal. He will begin to unfold the word of God. And hallelujah. And get close and begin. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I don't believe in going and fast for 40 days to hear from God. I don't know where we get that from. Every time I want to hear from God, I'm going to fast 40 days, 10 days. Man, you can talk to God now and hear from God now.
That's right. Amen.
That's religion. You have to fast 10 days to hear from God. How do you know what you heard? You know when Jesus went and fast for 40 days? You know what he heard from first? Anybody remember that story? Who? The devil. Who appeared to him first? Not the devil. But he fasted 40 days and 40 nights. So be careful when you want to hear the voice of God. Fasting. When I hear the devil.
All right.
Let me hear that alone.
That's all right.
Amen. All you have to do is love him and spend time with God and know. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
That's the truth.
Yeah, hallelujah. Talk to God right there and speak back to you. Some